Friends, welcome to worship with Houston and Killellan Kirk. As we gather from near and far, the Lord dwells in all our houses. We gather as one body around the Word of God, which sets us free. Good morning. Welcome to everyone joining us at Houston and Killellan Kirk for worship. This is shared in our YouTube channel and in our podcast and website. Please follow us on our YouTube channel if you can. In the echo of resurrection, a time arrives when it dawns in the soul. It can keep travelling without Jesus by our side. Such is the power of resurrection that charges the soul with life full enough to set it free from holding holy hands on the journey. This is resurrection power. Life lived in faith that takes our longing away from what has gone towards the horizon of what is yet to be. Jesus has ascended, and now in spirit he moves within us, resurrected within each of us to lead us anew. Let us worship God. We sing to God's glory and praise. Hymn 125, Lord of all being. Let us pray. God of glory, God of grace, we praise you. God beyond time, God beyond space, we bless you. God of the heavens, God made human, we worship you. God of compassion, God of creation, you have shaped us and made us your own. Forgive us when we reshape you and make you in our own image to better serve our own ends. Forgive us when we deny the light of your glory in others, preferring instead the wounding word or cutting comment, or promoting our own needs while ignoring our sisters and brothers. Forgive us when our thoughts, our words, our actions have failed to bring glory to your name. Forgive us also when we fail to forgive ourselves. Lord of restoration, of hope, may we see the love in ourselves. May we see the love in others. May we share the love you offer. And hear us now as we come together, uniting our voices one with the words that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever. Amen. Our intimations. This week I am on holiday for the next week, and the Reverend Dr. Alistair Shaw of Johnston St. Paul's Parish Church will be covering emergency pastoral care, and his details are on our website. Next Sunday we will join the moderator of the General Assembly, the Right Reverend Dr. Martin Fair, who will lead the church nationally in a Pentecost service, and details will be posted on Facebook and our website. Birthdays, it was John Jackson's 6th birthday earlier in the week, so a happy birthday, John. Hope you had a great time. And today is Jane Crawford's birthday. A very happy birthday to you, Jane. A big thank you for you leading our Sunday club in the Sunday club activities every week. I hope you have a very nice day with the family. This week, our readers, although known to us here in Houston Kirk, live in Kent. Wendy Loy and her son Andrew will read our scripture lessons. Our first reading is from Psalm 68, reading verses 1 to 10 and 33 to 35. Let's listen for God's word.
May God arise, may his enemies be scattered, may his foes flee before him. May you blow them away like smoke, as wax melts before the fire, may the wicked perish before God. But may the righteous be glad and rejoice before God. May they be happy and joyful. Sing to God, sing in praise of his name. Extol him who rides on the clouds. Rejoice before him. His name is the Lord. A father to the fatherless, a defender of widows, is God in his holy dwelling. God sets lonely in families. He leads out the prisoners with singing. But the rebellious live in a sun-scorched land. When you, God, went out before your people, when you marched through the wilderness, the earth shook. The heavens poured down rain. Before God, the one of Sinai, before God, the God of Israel. You gave abundant showers, O God. You refreshed your weary inheritance. Your people settled in it. But from your bounty, God, you provided for the poor. To him who rides across the highest heavens, the ancient heavens, who thunders with mighty voice, proclaim the power of God, whose majesty is over Israel, whose power is in the heavens. You, God, are awesome in your sanctuary. The God of Israel gives power and strength to his people. Praise be to God.
Thank you, Wendy. Our anthem this week is Singing Like a Bird, arranged by Bob Chilcott. It's sung by Laura McKee and Stephanie Bell.
Thank you.
Thank you, Laura and Stephanie, for another lovely anthem. Our second reading, read by Andrew Loy, is from the Gospel of John, John chapter 17, verses 1 to 11.
After Jesus said this, he looked toward heaven and prayed, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son may glorify you. For you granted him authority over all people that he might give eternal life to all those you have given him. Now this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. I have brought you glory on earth by finishing the work you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you before the world began. I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours. You gave them to me and they have obeyed your word. Now they know that everything you have given me comes from you. For I give them the words you gave me and they accepted them. They knew with certainty that I came from you, and they believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I'm not praying for the world, but for those you have given me, for they are yours. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine. And glory has come to me through them. I will remain in the world no longer, but they are still in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one.
Thank you, Andrew. Our next hymn, 502, Take My Life, Lord, Let It Be. Inspiration and guide this day, reminding us that we are not alone, but guided by your presence. Inspire us, ignite in us a longing for justice. So be it. Amen. This is the last Sunday of Easter, Next week, we celebrate Pentecost together with other churches across Scotland and indeed the world. Today, we look at a goodbye. Jesus saying goodbye as he is reunited with God. Celine Dion and Paul Anka, and It's Hard to Say Goodbye, sing, I'll never try to hold you back. I wouldn't try controlling you. If there's something else that you're looking for, I'll be the first to help you try. Believe me when I say, it's hard to say goodbye. We've worked through passages that are known as the farewell discourses. We've spoken about these over the last few weeks. Jesus says, I love you and always will. Love each other when I am gone. It's hard to say goodbye. Perhaps over these last few weeks, we can now appreciate how hard it is to miss friends or those we love. It's even harder when we consider the context. It's Thursday night in this part of John's account, the evening before Jesus' crucifixion. He knows that he will soon be leaving his disciples, leaving them to fulfill the mission that he's prepared for them. And he wants them to be prepared. The message of those last few chapters that we've looked at start to make sense. No matter what, through good times, through bad times, and there will be bad times, stay with me and I'll stay with you. And now just before he goes, he prays for them. What does he pray for? He doesn't pray that it will be easy, because he knows it won't be, because the world is captive to a desire that's alien to God's. It is driven by scarcity instead of abundance, fear instead of courage, selfishness instead of sacrificial love. Jesus, who came to bring abundant life for all, does not run away from danger. He offers love to all. So Jesus doesn't just pray for his disciples to get it easy. Rather, he prays that God will support them amid the challenges and that they remain in each other and in Jesus and God through the Spirit. And so Jesus' words, I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world. Protect them, are surely even more poignant to us today than ever before. These words are like a blessing prayed over us by Jesus as he leaves the world that he entered as a baby born in Bethlehem. Jesus lived, died, and rose again. And now it's time for him to return to God. But what's next? Jesus didn't only pray for his disciples. He takes it further and he prays for us. Yes, in the night before his death, Jesus prays for you and for me. He prays that we would know God's support and encouragement, that we would remain in fellowship with each other and with God, abide in me, and that we would find the strength and the courage to face the challenge that comes from living in the world, bearing witness in a place which seeks the opposite of the gospel of grace, abundance, courage and love. The message of ascension is this, that it's over to us. Jesus hands over the tools for us to continue the mission of God. The question is, how are we going to take up the challenge? We must love our neighbour like we've never loved before. We must genuinely care and take notice of people, and like Jesus did, we must call them by name, show them that they really belong. One of the fundamental things about being a disciple is bringing light, or being light in a dark situation. I've told this story before in church. As a small boy, this 19th century Edinburgh writer, Robert Louis Stevenson, would sit gazing out of the window in his parents' home, watching the evening shadows fade away and give way to darkness. The old-fashioned lamplighter, who each night would walk down the street lighting the gas street lamps, fascinated him. Stevenson is reported to have been so excited about this on one occasion, he shouted to his nanny, "Look, there's a man coming down the street punching holes in the darkness." Being a disciple of Jesus of Nazareth involves us punching holes in the darkness. Punching holes in the darkness of ignorance, fear, prejudice, inequality, loneliness and poverty. Being a disciple is a high calling, but it is an achievable one, and it's open to all. It's a topic which we should be discussing around every table we sit, with friends and family, with stranger alike, because the world today needs more than ever before for us to punch holes in the darkness. Bring the love of Christ to every street we walk, to every person we speak to. The followers of Jesus must find, create and serve community in the world. But our goal is to display to the world what the promise of community in heaven looks like. Jesus is crystal clear that there is no escape from the reality of the world. It is here we are meant to work and witness. Our mission is to live here, be salt and light here, be grace and truth here. Christians are woven into the fabric of the world, but are not to become indistinguishable from it. Our thread is divine, and it is this that gives texture and colour to the world where God weaves us into the patterns of life. God sent Jesus into the world. It comes as no surprise that Christ sends us into the world. In one very clear verse of Scripture, Jesus encapsulates his purpose and ours. To go into the world and not to get out of the world. The pattern of Christ's life, and therefore the life of Christ's church, is not to escape the world, but to engage with it. That is what the faithful followers of Jesus do. This is what disciples of the Lord today are shaped to be. So go into the world, where it is just as hard in our day as it was in Jesus' day, and punch holes in the darkness by showing compassion, acting in love, and speaking of hope. Glory be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forevermore, world without end. Amen. This is the time in the service when we would ordinarily uplift our offering. Thank you to everyone who continues to support us at this time, and ways you can give an offering are on our church website under the Finance tab or the Weekly Offering. Let us pray. Caregiver, life bringer, love sharer, we are the work of your hands. We thank you for life in all its fullness, for every breath and every heartbeat, for the many ways in which you have blessed us. Put our hands to work in your world, that our lives may become an offering that furthers your kingdom and glorifies your name forever. Intercessor God, as we stand listening at the door, eavesdropping on holy conversation. Just as your son prayed for the world and for his friends, so too we pray. We bring before you those places in the world where the darkness of injustice smothers and suffocates life and hope, where war and unrest are deemed good for business, where the few become wealthy at the expense of the many, where governments are self-serving, not the servants of all. God of justice, may the light of your liberating glory shine, and may it never be put out. We remember before you the church, your great and diverse body in the world. While we celebrate and give thanks for all we have in common, help us also to enjoy the diversity within the body, where ideologies are deemed more important than people, where hierarchies and power games have created toxic situations, where only the right kind of folk can come in. God of unity and diversity, may the light of your radical inclusion shine, and may it never be put out. We think of those who live with the darkness of doubt or anxiety, and who are troubled in mind and in spirit. For those who are ill, and for those who love them, for those who are dying, and for those who are grieving. For all those who are on our minds and in our hearts this morning. God of compassion, may the light of your love shine, and may it never be put out. Trusting in your unfailing love, knowing that you hear us, we offer up to you these prayers in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So be it. Amen. Following our final hymn, there's a word of benediction. We then sing the threefold Amen. And the doxology, praise God from whom all blessings flow. Our final hymn, 458, At the Name of Jesus.
Every tongue confessing, King of glory.
Go out into God's world, live in love and in peace. Share the message of God's kingdom. Initiate grace. And in the living of your lives, may God be glorified this day and always. And as you go, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the common life of the Holy Spirit be with you all forevermore.